is taqulu lil mu'minin, when you were saying to the mu'min, to the believers of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, alay yakfiyakum an yumiddakum rabbukum bi salasati alafin min al malaikati munzalin, is it not sufficient for you that your Lord helps you with 3,000 angels who will be sent down? So that was a good tiding for the Muslims that the Prophet gave, that don't fear, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will send. If you have to confront 3,000 people of the enemy, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will help you with 3,000 angels. Bala, why not? Because this glad tiding was given by Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is ratifying it. Why not? In tasbiru wa tattaqu, our Prophet had said 3,000. Instead, if you show patience and perseverance, and if you, O Muslims, have the real taqwa, وَيَعْتُوكُمْ مِنْ فَوْرِهِمْ هَذَا, if your enemy attacks you straight off, this very moment, يُمْدِدْكُمْ رَبُّكُمْ بِخَمْسَةِ عَلَافٍ مِنَ الْمَلَائِكَةِ مُسَوِّمِينَ, your Lord will help you with 5,000 angels who will come with their own standards, with their own marks. وَمَا جَعَلَهُ اللَّهُ إِلَّا مُشْتَعَلَكُمْ, and Allah made it only a good tidings, good news for you. وَلِتَطْمَئِنَّ بِهِ قُلُوبُكُمْ, so that your hearts are reassured with this. وَمَنْ نَصْرُ إِلَّا مِنْ عِنْدِ اللَّهِ, and there can be no help except from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah doesn't need to send 5,000 angels also. Allah can help without any angel, without sending any angel. He can act only by saying be and it becomes. But you know, for reassurance to you, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decided to send 5,000 angels. وَمَنْ نَصْرُ إِلَّا مِنْ عِنْدِ اللَّهِ الْعَزِيزِ الْحَكِيمِ, there can be no help except from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who is all powerful, who is all wise. لَيَقْطَعَ طَرَفًا مِنَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا, and Allah wanted to cut off a part and portion of the non-believers, أَوْ يَكْبِتَهُمْ, or to put them to humiliation. فَيَنْقَلِبُوا خَائِبِينَ, so that they had to return back frustrated. لَيْسَ لَكَ مِنَ الْأَمْرِ شَيْءٍ, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it is not for you to decide. Actually, what happened when the Prophet himself was wounded and blood gushed out of his cheek and two of his teeth were martyred, and when much of bleeding had happened and he felt weak and there was unconsciousness for some time, then a few words came out of his mouth. كَيْفَ يَهْدِ اللَّهُ قَوْمًا خَزَبُوا وَجْهَ نَبِيِّهِمْ بِالدَّمْ, how will Allah guide a people who colored the face of their Prophet with blood? Because the whole face of the Prophet was red with blood, because the wound was here on the cheek. The cheek bone, that was broken, and then from there the blood was gushing and the teeth were broken also. So when he said, كَيْفَ يَهْدِ اللَّهُ قَوْمًا خَزَبُوا وَجْهَ نَبِيِّهِمْ بِالدَّمْ, how can Allah guide the people who have colored and painted the face of their Prophet and Messenger of Allah with blood? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, it's none of your business. It's up to us. We shall decide whether to punish them or to guide them or to accept their tawbah. This is our exclusive, our domain. It's not your domain. لَيْسَ لَكَ مِنَ الْأَمْرِ شَيْءٌ, you don't have any authority in your hand. Mind you, O Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, أَوْ يَتُوبَ عَلَيْهِمْ, it is up to Allah. He may relent on them. He may accept their tawbah. أَوْ يُعَذِّبَهُمْ, or he may punish them. فَإِنَّهُمْ ظَالِمُونَ, there is no doubt. They are unjust. They have committed aggression against the Prophet. They deserve punishment. But maybe they repent and then Allah may relent on us. So it is not for you to decide, it is for us to decide. And please note what happened. The same Khalid ibn Walid, who was the main reason of all what happened there, he was given the title of sword of Allah. Khalidun Saifun min Suyufillah. Khalid is a sword from the swords of Allah. And that title was given by Muhammad himself sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because he later on he accepted Islam. لَيْسَ لَكَ مِنَ الْأَمْرِ شَيْءٍ أَوْ يَتُوبَ عَلَيْهِمْ أَوْ يُعَذِّبَهُمْ فَإِنَّهُمْ ظَالِمُونَ وَلِلَّهِ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ. And to Allah belongs whatever is in the skies and heavens and whatever is on earth. يَغْفِرُ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ وَيُعَذِّبُ مَنْ يَشَاءُ. The same ayah that came in the end of the Surah Al-Baqarah. He forgives whom he likes and he punishes whosoever he likes. وَاللَّهُ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. And Allah is essentially Ghafoor. He is forgiving and He is merciful. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu la ta'kulu riba. Oh you who profess to believe, don't eat, don't devour usury. Azafat muzafa, doubled and redoubled. Wattaqullah, and have fear of Allah. Fear Allah's punishment. La'allakum tuflihoon, so that you can prosper. Now because this ayah was revealed in the third year, this is the preliminary injunction about riba. The ayat which we have studied in Surah Al-Baqarah, they were revealed in the ninth year after Hijrah. That is the final commandment about riba. So this is the preliminary first commandment about riba here. وَاتَّقُوا النَّارَ الَّتِي أُعِدَّتْ لِلْكَافِرِينَ. Now just see. In this surah, in Surah Al Imran, there are 31 ayat which were revealed in the ninth year after Hijrah, when the deputation of the Christians of Najran came, and they are included in this surah, most of which was revealed in the third year. The ayat regarding the final prohibition of riba were revealed in the ninth year after Hijrah, and they are included in Surah Al Baqarah, which was revealed in the second year after Hijrah. So the resemblances, similarities between these surah, you know, they are coming up and they are adding up. وَاتَّقُوا النَّارَ الَّتِي أُعِدَّتْ لِلْكَافِرِينَ. وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ. Have Allah's taqwa, regard Him as you should regard Him, so that you can have falah, you can prosper. وَاتَّقُوا النَّارَ الَّتِي أُعِدَّتْ لِلْكَافِرِينَ. And have fear of the fire which has been prepared for the unbelievers. وَاطِعُوا اللَّهَ وَالرَّسُولَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ. And obey Allah and His Messenger, so that mercy is given to you, mercy is shown to you.